checking to see if you are still up for Ojai next weekend, because if you're not, I need to cancel the reservations before tomorrow. So, let me know. Yeah. Bye. Okay, why aren't you answering my calls or my texts, Kate? I just spoke to Jack and he said that you're at home. Call me. Finally! I was about to drive over and bang on your door.
Sorry.
Where have you been, babe?
I'm sorry, I forgot that my phone was on silent after my meeting today.
Oh, right. Yeah, that was today. How did it go?
Yeah, it was good. This rich Texan is moving forward with this hideous piece we've been trying to sell for months. So it was good.
The cowboy dude, right? Yeah, I remember him. We met at your opening.
Yeah, he's pretty hard to miss.
Mob man. He was hitting on me at the bar aggressively. It was gross.
Really?
Mm-hmm. But luckily, your gem of a husband came and rescued me, so.
Always the hero.
Well, I talked to him earlier, and he said he's happy for you to do the girls' weekend. I'm hoping you still want to go. Hey, Max! Max! Shh! God, he is obsessed. obsessed with barking at the new neighbors. I don't know what that's about. I literally can't leave him at home at all anymore. Sorry. Anyways, I've made reservations for massages, and there are these amazing hot springs that we should check out. Maybe we could do Saturday afternoon before dinner. The hotel has a natural wine tasting. Figured you'd be into that. Kate?
Yeah?
What do you think?
I can't go.
What? Why? What's going on? Darling?
Jack is cheating on me.
Oh my God. I'm so sorry. Sweetheart, what happened? Have you talked to Jack?
I think it's been going on since I was at Art Basel last year.
How do you know?
I just had a feeling in my gut. It was really intense when I was leaving. Then when I was gone, he could never answer my phone calls. It was weird. He always had to call me back.
I don't think that means anything. It's Jack. He's always so busy at work. All he does is work.
I found a dinner receipt in his car from Palm Springs. He told me he was out there looking for furniture.
So? I mean, he could have been telling you the truth.
Yeah, because we need more furniture. If he was telling me the truth, why wouldn't he just say that he was going there when I was gone?
I don't, maybe he was looking for a birthday present for you.
5 months in advance, Ella?
I don't know, Kate. It's possible, though. He does love to surprise you. He's always loved surprising you. Kate, are you there?
Yeah, I'm still here.
I can't imagine the two of you not being together. What was that? Are you okay?
I'm fine. You just dropped the glass.
Shit, did you hurt yourself? Kate? Kate, listen.
I think it's strange that we've been married for 3 years and now he decides to start locking his phone.
Oh, come on. I mean, I keep my phone locked all the time in case I lose it. I think most people in the world do that.
He said that too. I don't know anymore. I really didn't think Jack was capable of doing something like this to me.
It does not have to mean that your relationship is over. And I'm sure if it happened, it was just a one-time thing.
It wasn't.
Maybe you two need to reconnect. I mean, you've both been so fucking busy with your careers recently, and do you think anything has changed since you took over the gallery?
Are you saying this is my fault?
Not what I'm saying, but I would imagine that it's been hard for Jack when you're always at work, you know?
That's bullshit, Ella.
No, Kate. I didn't mean it like that.
That's bullshit. You're saying that it's okay for Jack to be at work for 12 hours a day, but then when my career gets off the ground, he can't handle it, and he gets to go off and do whatever he wants, fuck whoever he wants, or whatever it is he's doing.
I'm sorry. That's not how I meant it. Trying to be insensitive. I really do not think that you need to make a decision in this exact moment. You know, you two have been together for so long, and people fuck up, Kate. They do. It happens. It doesn't mean it's worth throwing away an entire relationship. I mean, my parents got through it. Kate?
Yeah.
I know Jack loves you.
It's crazy. We've been friends for 15 years already, huh? I remember when you first walked into that class.
I remember that. I was so nervous.
You're wearing that great David Bowie t-shirt. I think all the guys instantly had a crush on you.
Oh, do still have the t-shirt, though.
And our blood oath at graduation, you remember that? You're so stupid.
Yeah, it was a lot of blood. I had to get 2 stitches.
What was our promise?
We promised each other that if we both weren't married by 60, that we would find a beautiful farmhouse in the middle of nowhere and live there together. Grow old. Full grey gardens. My darling, it's gonna be okay. It is. I just don't think that you should jump to conclusions until you know.
I do know.
Kate.
I'll let you tell Jack that I won't be here waiting for him.